we are asked to use integer chips to represent 0, 4, and negative 5 two different ways. A positive chip equals positive 1, a negative chip equals negative 1. And therefore, one way to represent 0 would be to use one positive chip and one negative chip. These two chips combine and simplify to 0. Once we recognize this is a model for 0, we can represent 0 in as many ways as we wish, as long as we pair each positive chip with a negative chip. For example, a second way to model 0 would be to use two positive chips and two negative chips, or three positive chips and three negative chips, and so on. There are an infinite number of ways to model 0 using integer chips. And now let's model 4 two different ways. One way to model positive 4 would be to use four positive chips. And now let's think of a second way that we can model positive 4. Let's begin with four positive chips again. From here, we can still model 4 if we add models of 0. So if we add another positive chip and then a negative chip, this still models 4 because we have positive 4 here and 0 here. So once again, we can add as many zeros as we wish, and this will still model 4. So if we add another positive chip and another negative chip, this is still a model for positive 4. Now let's model negative 5 two different ways. One model for negative 5 would be 5 negative chips. For a second way, let's begin with 5 negative chips again. And then from here, we can simply add models of 0. So if we add a positive chip and a negative chip, this is a different model for negative 5. These 5 negative chips represent negative 5. This positive chip and negative chip represent 0. And again, we can add as many zeros as we wish, and this will still model negative 5. For example, here's another model for negative 5. I hope you found this helpful.